A lot of us have had our fair share of troubles and struggles throughout our lives. Not enough money, strained relationships, rough jobs, or a lack of a job, etc. If you are currently facing dilemmas in your life and don't know how to fix them, then this is the ritual for you. I must warn you, this ritual involves conjuring up an entity. No, not a ghost, not a demon, not a monster, not a force, an entity, a being of unknown origin. If this already concerns you, then turn away. This is not for you. If you insist on continuing, I have another warning. Basically, you are going to be submitting your current problems in life to the entity, the Maiden, in hopes she will hear your pleas and miraculously fix them. This doesn't mean you're going to get rich, or get your dream job, or bring a dead one back to life, or marry a celebrity. If you're interested in such luxuries, this is not the ritual for you. If you are still on board, I have one final warning. This ritual will put your deepest morality and ethics to the test, and they will be judged. The result can be several different outcomes based on how the Maiden judges you. One of the results is entirely unpleasant, so come into this ritual with the purest intentions. You can complete this ritual by yourself or with one other person. The rules are slightly different if you do it with another person. Be sure to read carefully. You will need note cards or some sort of small paper to write on, a writing utensil for you and the other person if you have one, a lighter or matches, a small container, an old-fashioned service bell, such as the kind you see on the front desks at hotels, and a dark room. Follow these steps exactly, or the Maiden will not hear or respond to you, or in some rare cases, may start causing weird events to happen around you later on. These are the steps for performing the ritual by yourself. If you are doing the ritual with a friend, be sure to read both of these instructions, and the ones afterwards. Go to your selected dark room with the note cards, writing utensils, small container, and bell in hand, and the lighter or matches in your pocket. Shut the door. Lock it to make sure no one comes in and messes up the ritual. Set your container down on a flat surface, such as a desk or counter, away from anything that's very flammable, such as carpet or cloth. Set the bell right next to it. This is where you will perform the whole ritual. Do not leave the vicinity of the flat surface. Throughout the ritual, you are never to look directly behind you. Try to only look at your note cards and the container. Grab your note cards. Write down a current issue you have and want fixed, i.e., need a better job, get along better with my roommate, find that missing item, etc. Remember, nothing too luxurious or over the top, only down-to-earth current problems. Once you have written down the problem you want fixed, grab your lighter or matches, hover it and the note card over the container, and burn the note card, letting its ashes fall into the container. Ring the bell once. Continue writing one note at a time, burning it, and letting the ashes collect in a corner for each note. For each subsequent note burned into the container, ring the bell an extra time. For example, after burning the second note, ring the bell two times. After burning the third note, ring the bell three times, and so on and so forth. Only go up to a total of five notes. Any more will cause the Maiden to never respond to you, even if you try doing the ritual again another time. Once you are finished burning the last note and ringing the bell for the final times, wait a few seconds and ring the bell one last time. This lets the maiden know you are finished with the ritual. You may now leave your position and open the door, turn on the lights, and leave the room. Discard of the ashes if you wish. The maiden has already seen your pleas. You have already invited the entity in. Be sure to keep the bell. Over the next few days, everything should be relatively normal. The maiden will be taking this time to judge you. Based off of what you wrote, the entity will decide whether or not you are a person of legitimately good morals and ethics, and that you had the purest intentions when summoning it. If you are completing this ritual with a friend, do the same steps as above, but keep these few extra rules in mind. You both will write your own individual notes. When you are writing the notes, you must not be facing the other person, and you must not let them see what you wrote. This is how the maiden judges your character even further. Be careful of what you say. Wait until you are finished writing each note, then have one of you burn theirs first, and the other burn theirs next, and one of you ring the bell. Remember to ring it one extra time for each subsequent note. Then you both move on to your next note. If you move on to another note without your partner, the maiden may judge you unfavorably. You will know once the maiden has decided upon your result. There are several possible results. I will list them below. A. If the problems you submitted to her begin to almost miraculously fix themselves, chances are you've passed the test and received a good result. Whenever you are home, you will hear the echoing ring of the service bell any time the maiden is about to or has recently fixed a problem. Be careful, however. If weird things start to happen around you, the person you did the ritual with, and the place in which you did the ritual, this 100% of the time means you have reached the bad result. Your life may be in danger. Sometimes it will seem your problems are being fixed and that you have gotten a good result. However, you may start to experience a mix of miraculous problem fixes and also bizarre and sometimes traumatic events. These events can range from power outages around the home to things as awful as the sudden death of a loved one. This means the maiden, while not deeming you entirely malicious or selfish, believes you need to be taught some kind of life lesson, and the entity will also do so through any extreme means necessary. If you get result B, as I said above, your life may be in danger. The maiden will make your life a living hell, and may even bring legitimate harm to you or others around you. The maiden may even play with you and ring the service bell anytime it causes something bad to happen, or even do the exact opposite of what you wished. There's nowhere you can run. She will always find you. This is why I strongly recommend you come into this ritual understanding the depth and purity behind your desires.